Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You are tuned in to Walk in Purpose with Angela over here on WBNN. We're getting ready to go live on Blog Talk Radio. So please share this in your circle of friends. We're going to be live streaming from Lagos, Nigeria. I have three amazing guests that's going to be stopping by. We're talking about the state of Black America, the plot to destroy democracy. I'm excited about tonight. Waiting on my guests to chime on in. Yeah, I'm going to be multitasking tonight, so y'all bear with me on tonight. I am screaming live on LinkedIn, YouTube, and Twitch. So please share in your circle of influence. I'm going to go live on Facebook. On my phone. Just a second. Live. Waiting on my guests to show up. Hello. I am live on Blog Talk Radio. Waiting on my guests. We are live. I do not own rights to any of the music that may be playing in the background. We are live on Blog Talk Radio. I repeat, we are live on Blog Talk Radio. I do not own the rights to any of the music that will be playing in the background. And for my guests to show up. Brother O and Q. I'm in Q. And now we're waiting on my guests to show up in Q. I'm waiting on one of my guests to call me. Well, we're about to go live. Good evening, and welcome to America, the plot to destroy democracy. Who is the true stranger? What is family? What part are you playing in what's taking place in this world right now? How are you bringing change around you? Welcome. Tonight, we will be touching on a little touchy subject. So I just want everyone to just relax and enjoy the show. The Queen Educate, Empower, and Encourage. I want to thank you guys for joining our 3,000 312th presentation of Ngozi Time Multimedia LLC. We are live from Lagos, Nigeria. You can call in at 516-453-9133. Make sure you press 1 to join the conversation. I'm going to start my show off. I have a special guest that's going to join us. This guest is currently incarcerated, and he's going to be joining us tonight live from behind the walls. He's going to be sharing with us. Jerome, are you there?
Yes, absolutely. How are you?
I am great. If you would, please introduce yourself to those that are tuned in on tonight.
Okay, well, first, I would like to thank you and your audience for this great opportunity to with and through you all. You've been successful on this platform because your voice is hearing speaking, and your audience is receptive to that. Hopefully, I can have the same congruence. My name is Jerome Giovanni Wilson. I go by Isomoto Asgari. I'm the founder of the Texas Liberation Collective. I am the CEO of the Immortal Media Group. And our tag is Think, Learn, Teach, Empower. And that's what I'm standing on. And so, you know, we have a lot in common. That's why we're building these inroads right now, because of the education and the empowerment that I'm trying to do and that you're trying to do.
Well, I definitely thank you for joining us. I thank you for joining us on tonight. If you would, if you can, is it possible for hold on. Is it possible for you to mute your line?
Yeah, well, yeah, I can cover it up, yes.
Can you mute your line? Just for a second, I'm going to allow the other guests to introduce themselves, and then I'm going to come back to you, because tonight we have a chance to meet each one of my guests. Each one of them are authors, and they are Brown Kings, and I really want them to be able to chime in on this conversation. I know that your time is limited, so I definitely want you to be able to chime in, but I want to be able to introduce the other guests that are on. We have Mr. Ware on. Mr. Ware, if you could come on and briefly introduce yourself.
Hey, my name is Andre Ware. Hey, Angela, thanks for having me on the program. I really appreciate that. Anyway, my name is Andre Ware. I'm chiming in from Chicago, Illinois, south side of Chicago. I am the author of The Purpose of Being and also The Naked Eye. The Purpose of Being is a poetry book. The Naked Eye is also an inspirational poetry book, but ends in prose. Both are inspirational motivation.
And I definitely thank you for joining us on tonight. Our topic is the state of Black America. And I want everybody to be able to chime in. Mr. Wilson, I definitely want to hear your take on the state of Black America from behind the walls. If you would, please.
So what's going on in Black America behind the walls is this. We're enslaved right now. And it's about the class, the lower class that we happen to be in. What they are doing to us is handling us through our labor. We're laboring, we're not getting paid for it, and a lot of us aren't standing up to it. And so if you have a voice, they want to quiet you. This is one of the topics that I speak of in my book, Glass Wallpaper, The Political Eulogy of a Political Prisoner. And they actually wrote me disciplinary cases for publishing this book. They took my visitation privileges, they took my telephone privileges, commissary privileges, gave me cell restrictions and everything, because what I'm supposed to do according to them is come to this prison and be a slave and do what they tell me to do and speak and spoken to. And if I speak on my own behalf, to be an independent Black man, even from behind the wall, then I suffer the consequences. As a matter of fact, today, well, I'm going to say a couple weeks ago, when we had an air-conditioned room in this prison, there's only one room in Texas that's air-conditioned. And if you want to go to that room that's called the respite area, they make you sit on the floor, and you can't talk. There's no talking in there. So whereas you have freedom of speech out there, if you really feel like you have freedom of speech out there, which is another conversation, we don't have it in here. You see what I'm saying? And the plumbers, the electricians, the HVAC guys, the doom sweeping, no one gets paid to work. Yet Black America celebrates Juneteenth, and they say it's our holiday. But it can't be our holiday if the slaves were never freed, not only in the state of Texas, but anywhere else that there's forced involuntary servitude. So that's what's going on. And if I speak out on this, there are Black people that think that I'm tripping with the holiday and don't want us, Texas Liberation Collective, we have Team One, Texas Team One, we're all moving on this together. This isn't just me. We're trying to get the country to realize that if we're going to celebrate Juneteenth, we're respecting what we have going on, and there's over 2 million prisoners, how about we make Juneteenth real? Because while you're having barbecues and parades and celebrating and bumping your music and eating everything, we're in here working for free. So how would you feel if you were here, and that means the men and women in prison, the Black and white people in prison, the Mexicans, everybody in prison, how would you feel if you were looking on TV, watching the news, listening to your mama, your brother, your sister, and everybody celebrate Juneteenth when they're making you go to work? If you don't go to work, you're going to miss your invitation. If you don't go to work, they can snatch parole and not give you parole. So with that being said, the 13th Amendment has been abolished except for voluntary servitude. And that's what's going on behind the wall in all 50 states, you know what I'm saying, and in the federal colonies of prisons. And this is what we're trying to bring to the limelight. I'm an author. I own a business. If I'm creating, right now, if I wanted to buy my own health insurance, I should be able to pay for it if I got the money. I need glasses right now. There's no arms on my glasses. I got a string holding these glasses up to my face right now. They won't put me on a medical chain and send me get glasses, but I have money to buy my own glasses. So what's the problem with letting me buy my own health care if that's what I want to do? You see what I'm saying? So they make us look like we're dependent on the state, and they say that the taxpayers take care of us, but when we try to do something to take care of ourselves, we're distant for it. So it's a 52 fake out, and it's an illusion, and Juneteenth is a farce until we make it real. It's not a boycott. It's not a protest. It's a way to educate the people and say, hey, are y'all celebrating that? Really disrespecting the slaves, because still here, the slaves were not free on Juneteenth, because if they were, what am I? Did I get all that out?
Wow. That was a lot, and that was deep. We got a track, and then we'll be right back. Wow. They give you something to think about. Brother O, track. Thank you. Welcome back. We are live from Lagos, Nigeria. You can call in at 516-453-9133. Press 1 to join the conversation brought to you by Ngozi Time Multimedia LLC. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Walk in Purpose with Angela. I have my special guest still in queue, Mr. Jerome. I want you to share how individuals can support you as an author in your business. How can they support what you are doing and what you are trying to do?
So, as far as my personal case, I have a website called justiceforjeromedevonnywilson.org where I have a breast cancer movement there. My grandmother is a breast cancer survivor, so I started Peak Poetry Nation, which grew into Peak Party Nation, and I have a book there, a poetry book, that we sell to give proceeds to the Breast Cancer Awareness Campaign. And my book class, Wallpaper, The Poetical Eulogy of a Political Prisoner, is also available there. And we accept donations, which go to funding the site and getting out the literature and helping with the political arm of Texas Liberation Collective to get the word out about what's going on with these unpaid wages and a bunch of things. As a matter of fact, we're releasing a three-part series called Exposing the Lone Star Chamber, the Lone Star Chamber of Enslavement. The first part is already posted. I've been having technical difficulties because I've been enslaved for 20 years, but part two and part three will be published within the next week or two, so I would like you to stay tuned for that. If you really want to learn about how they can make it look like there was a crime boom, then you would want to read these documents. What I mean by that is, in the 90s, they came and tripled the amount of prisons in the state. There was only 30-something prisons in Texas, and I say only because Texas is the biggest state, but there were 30-something prisons in this state. During the Clinton era, the prison rate climbed to 110 or 111 prisons, but the crime rate didn't. So you have to ask yourself, well, wait a minute, if the crime rate didn't climb, make sense that they created all these prisons. They didn't create more courtrooms. So they made all these prisons and pushed all these people into prisons, but then all these people in prison fighting to get out, so they filed an appeal. Well, wait a minute. Why didn't I build more courtrooms so we could get out of here for being wrongfully incarcerated? This is why you're seeing all these people now getting released on DNA. Eyewitness testimony is trash. Blood spatter testimony is trash. Well, I don't know about fingerprint testimony. Bite mark testimony is trash. Everything's being disproved now because it was never reliable science. So they came and made this wave look like it was a bunch of crimes taking place when it never was that. They just needed to fill these prisons because they can fleece us of our labor. McDonald's, Victoria's Secret, all these places that you buy these products, when you buy them pennies and them bras, when you buy them McDonald's, know that slave labor is producing these things. And a lot of people don't. And then the people that do know still buy them. So when you spend your money with people who are fleecing the prisoners of their labor, you're supporting slavery. When you're voting people into the Senate and the House of Representatives that are not trying to repeal the 13th Amendment that said that slavery has been abolished except for the convicted felon, you are supporting slavery. And if the government, which is a corporation, is for the people, for we the people, and they work for we the people, and you're voting them in place, who are the real masters? We can't even just keep blaming them on them if you keep putting the same people in there, like Carter G. Woodson said, and expecting a different result. Carter G. Woodson is who wrote The Miseducation of a Negro, and we're about to republish that book. As a matter of fact, you'll find it on my website come February. But that's what you can do to support this movement. Justice What's Wrong, DivineWilson.org. And not only that, educate yourself, because it's bigger than what I have going on and what the Texas Liberation Collective has going on. Sometimes you got to start asking questions because they're redefining things. Y'all actually had a conversation with somebody that acted like they didn't know what slavery was. She actually asked me if we were wanting wages for our labor. Like, she's going to go to work for free. Are you going to work for free? Of course you're not. So why should we work for free? You know, and so if you educate yourself and you start looking at things, there's a lot of things going on that you may not. And you're crazy celebrating Juneteenth when slaves stood around, like Frederick Douglass refused to celebrate the 4th of July while they were slaves. It's the exact same thing. But that would really, really help if you educate yourself, and you can begin by reading some of my material, especially Exposing the Lone Star Chamber, that three-part series. You can go there and search Exposing the Lone Star Chamber on Justice What's Wrong Divine. You can read the first document, and the next couple of documents will be up there soon within the next probably 7 to 10 days. My team will have them up.
Well, I want to thank you for stopping by and sharing with us on tonight. We have another track by International Internet Radio Hall of Fame disc jockey, Brother O.
Well, I just said all the world.
Caller number one in queue. Caller number one, if you would state where you're calling from and your name.
Hi, Angela. Jerry.
Hey, Jerry. How are you? You
just wanted to call and say hello to you, especially and to your guest. I mean, what a story he has.
Yeah.
I just pray that he gets everything out there that needs to be said and done, and I hope he gets justice for even being wrongly incarcerated.
Thank you very much. Thank you very
much. Wow, Jerry. You know, I got to come on and say something while we get our lines together, because I know the brother is calling from prison. There's a little bit of feedback, but, you know, we love you, and you're taking your time.
Thank
you. Right now, you're not doing well.
Yes.
And it's so good for Buddy being in and our host, you know, always persevering. Your comments on just the injustices, definitely in the prison. We all know that they build more prisons than schools. But, you know, your opinion that I'll bring back Ezra on.
Okay, so I've shared a little bit about my mother's family, you know, growing up in New York. Most of them were in jail for terrible things, you know. And they weren't wrongly incarcerated. So when I hear stories like this, it just breaks my heart, because we need to do something about this. And, you know, black, white, whatever the color is, you know, and especially for the African Americans, but we have to do something about this. And I'm not quite sure, like, what to do. I used to work with the court system here in my county. I was very close to a lot of the people that worked there, including the municipal court judge. And we used to do things in our county, but I don't know what I would be able to do to help Texas. but we have to do something, Brother O, because this is just craziness. It's not fair, it's not okay, and it's not humane.
You know, I'm glad you said that because that's actually so important about empowerment. We gotta give the people what they want. No fake news. Stop racism. Stop poverty. Know your purpose. Walk in your purpose.
Yeah.
And now, the Honorable Ezra Thomas Smith talking to you.
Wow. Well, Jerry, I want to thank you for coming on and sharing. I tell you, this topic is really, really touchy for me and all that I stand for. I just want people to understand that they have a purpose. And, you know, we can't do it. We can't do what we are called to do spiritually if they keep us bound in our flesh. And that's what's happening. You know, I get so choked up when we talk about this subject because it's just like, you know, people talk about it like it's been a year ago when it hadn't been that long ago. You know, I look at some of the reports and different things. You talk about the 60s and 50s. You know, that's not too far removed. And people act like it's been a long time ago. But we as people, we can't keep seeing stuff happen. And this is everybody. We're not pulling race cards now. This is everybody because we see stuff happening and we walk right past like we didn't just see that happen. It just because it's not happening to us, that's what we do. But Brother O, can you play a track really quick?
I sure will. And I want to thank the International Radio Hall of Fame broadcast.
Hello, this is a free call from an inmate at Connolly Unit. This call is being recorded and is subject to monitoring. To accept this free call, press 1 to refuse this free call. Or an offender prepaid debit account, press 5. If you would like to permanently thank you for using Securus, you may start the conversation now.
Thank you.
I had to give a shout out to my big brother O for that soundtrack of our lives, Black Power. I tell you, he's always over there jamming. I tell you, that's why he is inducted into the International Internet Hall of Fame as a disc jockey and a producer. He be doing his thing, and I appreciate him. I appreciate him in so many ways. I appreciate him for allowing us this opportunity. I want to bring up Andre Ware. He's patiently been waiting over there in queue. I want him to come up and share just a little bit. This young man has been out in Vegas enjoying an award, and I want him to share that world on tonight. Because I stand up and they do what is needed because we need role models. We need examples. We need people that look like us doing positive things so that we can have something to strive for. So I want to thank you. And I want you to share exactly what that award is all about. And I want you to share a little bit about your poetry because we have some poets on this network.
Well, first I want to say thank you. I won an award from Distinguished Author Award from Kill from Dag. It was actually an honor. The Purpose of Being, which is a poetry collection, I actually won for that. And that, man, that was a blessing. But before I really get into that, I want to play Devil's Advocate because I know what they were saying about Black America and how it's affecting us, you know. I was looking at the Urban League's report, and they were saying that it's a negative outlook. Now, I'm not going to dwell on the negative, because we already know about the disparities. Everybody always talks about the disparities. I'm going to challenge your listeners. Instead of focusing on the disparities, how about, like that young man said, educate ourselves. Go to school. Open up that business. Be a banker. Open up a bank. Open up a mortgage company. Serve your community. Serve your people. You know, that's what we need. Because other than that, we'll always be talking about these disparities. That's not solving the problem. We are the solution. And I really mean that. Now, going back to Vegas. Vegas was a nice experience. Gina Gaston, she's a good friend. The fact actually acknowledged the book, and I really didn't think the book was going to win an award. And when I won it, you know, I was grateful. Do you mind if I share a poem?
I do not. Go ahead.
I'm going to read one poem from the book that won. It's titled The Strength, and I want this to resonate with your listeners. Before man came into existence, there was dust. Now that man has power and authority, he has learned to lust. Power should be used as a tool and not be given to a man-made fool. Power should go to the one who truly deserves, as long as the moral values of life are well preserved. Power is very extravagant and brings about its own prosperity, whether used for selfish gain or creating various pain. Power will always live throughout the human race, so let's put it to use and pray for grace. And I want y'all to marinate on that, because as we think about the state of Black America, challenge yourself once again. Get involved in politics. Run for these political office. You know what I mean? I mean, everybody won't change, but everybody just looking around seeing who's going to make the first move. It's us. It is us.
Wow. And that's what I say all the time. You know, we are the change that we desire to see. And I tell people all the time, we may not see the things right now immediately as we're doing them, but change will come if we continue, if we stay on this journey, if we stay on this fight, if we continue to push. We don't give up. But we have to be willing to step out and do something. It's that get up and do. We can't keep talking about it. We got to be about it.
Exactly. And I can understand being vulnerable. Most people are afraid. So what if you fail? You got a voice. Speak up. I mean, I'm using myself as an example. It's not easy for me to do what I do. But you know what? When I leave this earth, I want to know I made a difference. Instead of just talking, I'm about action, not just talk. We do another talking from the 60s, from the 70s, from the 80s. It's time for action.
That's it. That's what I'm talking about. But that goes back to that number four. How are you bringing about change? What are you doing? And that's the question that we should be asking ourselves. What are you doing to change where you were yesterday, so that you can change your community for tomorrow? And then when we begin to change our community, that's when we begin to change the world. And then the universe will begin to change. But it starts with us.
And that's true.
It starts with us. So we have a track.
And to give you an example.
Hold on. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
And to give you an example of what I'm doing in the world. Mm-hmm. It's just not that I'm a poet and I'm an author. Presently, I'm a member of Rosemont Community Association. Also, I serve as a special service area commissioner in the Roseland community. I vote, and I encourage others to vote as well. And I also used to serve as a precinct counselor for my state rep. I did that in the past. These are things that volunteer, my brothers and sisters. It don't cost anything but time. You need to get out here, do what you need to do. It's just a matter of serving. We all here to serve.
Wow. Mr. Jerome, do you have anything to add? Because I know that you're calling in from behind the wall, so I know your time is limited. Do you have anything to add before we go to this track?
Well, first of all, shout out to the South Side of Shine. I'm from Gary, Indiana, brother, so you already know what it is. But he hit it on the nose. You know, I always tell people that I'm a servant, no matter what I'm doing. I'm not only a servant, but I'm always a student. Even when I'm educating somebody and I know I'm educating somebody, I'm still learning from them. And I go into every situation with an open mind, which is why when I start doing the Juneteenth thing, those who I write for, he was like, well, why are you calling it a protest? Why are you calling it a boycott? So I had to slide back and look at it and say, okay, that might turn some people away. So we just go. gonna call it the Juneteenth situation. You know what I'm saying? But there's always give and take and things of that nature. But, you know, being from Chicago, brother knows that vote stands for voices of total empowerment. And I'm a brother of growth and development. So I'm standing on politics, economics, social development, unity, and education, and things of that nature. And that's what we need, because he can't do it by himself. Angela can't do it by herself. I can't do it by myself. And I see stagnation. I'm actually surrounded by stagnation because these brothers get the fight beat out of them. They're asleep all day. You look up, you've been here 20 years. So I recalibrate. Instead of doing like a New Year's resolution, I pick a goal, and every 3 months I recalibrate. I look at what I've got accomplished in 3 months, whatever I'm slipping on, whatever I need to improve. I'll add it to my wheel of fortune. I've got three things I need to do more of and three things that I need to do less of. And procrastination is always one of them. The struggle is an action word. As he said, as you said, we've all got to contribute to the struggle. And as you said, it's from the community and it comes from the house. So if he raises his children with the same outlook that he has, they're going to raise their children with the same outlook that he has. And it's going to continue that way. That's where our legacies come from. And you want your legacy to be that dash in between when you was born and when you died. You know, what did you do while you were here? Did you waste time? That's a precious commodity. How much time do you have to waste? Because I don't have none. I've been here 20 years. I don't have a second to waste. And ain't nobody going to tell me how I'm going to live it. You know, I'm going to go out there and do what's best for me and my people. And that's what I would like to see everybody else doing. Do what's best for you and your people. That don't mean giving a handout, but a hand up. You know what I'm saying? We're not necessarily looking for a handout. We're looking for a hand up sometimes. Sometimes we need that. And I'm always willing to give it. So, you know, that's why I'm happy.
Wow, that's powerful. And I thank you because you could be so, your mind could be so many other places from being behind that wall, but your strength and I thank you. I thank you on tonight. We have a track by International Internet Radio Hall of Fame, my big brother, this jockey, Brother O.
Well, first of all, all eyes and mine too, right? I love what Andre said. Andre, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Man, let me tell you something, man. You must have been in my head. That's got to be the spirit of God, because the next soundtrack is all about what you just said. Not talking about the disparities, but talking about the gracious power of positivity. And I go to the great Curtis Mayfield right now. You know why? Because we're a winner. Stop playing with me.
We have fun and drama.
Welcome back. Welcome back to Walk in Purpose with Angela. We are live from Lagos, Nigeria. You can call in at 516-453-9133. Make sure you press that one so that you can join the conversation. We actually have caller number two in queue. Caller number two, if you can tell me where you're calling from and state your name, please.
Peace and blessings, Angela, and peace and blessings to your guest. This is Sister Bestie the Trooper.
Hey, Sister Bestie, how you doing?
Hi, my sister. I'm enjoying your conversation and your guest. I appreciate the subject, and I just have one proverb that I wanted to read. It was something that I wanted to mention, but I don't know if I should talk about it, but I will. Proverbs 28:1, the wicked run away when no one is chasing them, but the godly are as bold as lions. I wanted to talk about the murder of the young lady that so many people are talking about around the world, and how this young lady was treated so badly by the people that she thought was her friends. And we're finding more and more of that in our community. And I was heartbroken when I saw the video and saw what they had done to this young lady. And even though we're in trouble and find that we don't know how to go to the Creator to try to heal ourselves. This jealousy and envious from the people around you and your family, it's got to stop. It's got to stop. I saw that and I was just heartbroken. And that's what I wanted to say, you know, because we often, on this podcast, we often try to talk about violence, about stopping the violence. And sometimes I feel like we steady talking and they're not listening. So what do you have to say about that, Angel?
Well, I was heartbroken when I heard that. At the same time that I heard that, you know, I also heard about the three other African Americans from North Carolina that lost their lives in the same area because of carbon monoxide poisoning. You know, I'm just that was just the fact that they cover up stuff and hide stuff, and it's just sad. And the way we treat each other as people, you know, we supposed to be moving forward, not moving backwards. And it's just sad. I mean, it's just sad to look and to think that all that our ancestors went through so that we can have some things. But yet we still we fight each other, we kill each other, you know, and then we go on like it's just another day. You know, I'm here in Atlanta. Every day I see and hear 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people getting shot, killed. And then sometimes it be people that you know. And it's just sad because it was a time when I would see stuff like that and I would be like, that won't happen to me. That won't happen to me. And now it's happening so regular, people just looking and walking on like, it's just norm. Like, what is the norm now? Like, when we gonna say enough is enough? You know, I'm to the point, I can't sit down no more and be quiet. I can't be quiet, you know. So it is what it is. A lot of people gonna get tired of me. That little TikTok saying that You gonna get sick of me? Yeah, that's what it's gonna be. You gonna get sick of me. Because
yeah. And I wanted to ask you one more thing. I also found out that there is a 34% increase in black women's death. Black young women, black children, and black women. I was on the internet, and his brothers were talking about the Jezebel. But as far as we know, Angela, there was only one Jezebel. And she was prophesied for her death. So there are men trying to claim that a high percentage of the black women are Jezebels. And that does not make sense. So they're saying they're Jezebels, so you got a right to kill them? It was only one Jezebel. Even her daughter was in bed. But it was one woman that was prophesied that she would end up in the way she was. So all black women are not Jezebels. And you cannot use that excuse to kill the sisters and mothers and daughters that the womb you came out of. So I wanted to say that. And if you have an opinion on that, I will hang up. But I thank you so much. I love you, Angela.
I want you. You can't run off. You can't run off that quick. You are. We have to tell people who we are when we call in to support. Yeah, we have to care people who we are so they know who we are. You are. Tell them who you are.
I'm Sister Bessie the Trooper from the front porch. I will be back on the 9th.
And sometimes we just don't like to share what we accomplished, but she is the Internet Radio Hall of Fame broadcasting nominee. Sister Bessie. Well, thank you for jumping on and sharing your insight. You always have some amazing insight, and always I thank you for your support, and I love you, Sister Bessie. We have caller number 3. Thank you. We have caller number 3 in queue. Caller number 3, if you can state your name and where you're calling from.
Hello, Angela. This is Tiana Speaks, and I'm calling from Jersey. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great. It's a great show. I wanted to share my thought regarding the first person who spoke, and I appreciate the last person who spoke. I definitely care his sentiments. We take things for granted when we're on the outside. You know, we can eat. We can go outside when we want, you know. And right before he told a story about, you know, having to be in one room with air conditioning, we can't speak, I had got up and turned my air conditioning on because the house got hot. It's really a luxury for some people, too. And we don't realize how lucky we are to do so many things, even if we fall off anyone we want, when we want. When you listen to people talk, you know, I mean, anybody in all the listeners who are listening to this show right now, I want to really open your eyes and you listen to these people talk. I hope that you cherish your freedom every day. You get to go to the bathroom when you want. And I'll say it again, eat whenever you want. You can go outside. You can take a picture of the moon. You can look at the sun. Imagine all these things being taken away from you if you were convicted of a crime that you did not commit. Your life would never be the same, even if the person isn't. You know, and one thing I want to bring up, and I want your opinion, and if you've asked someone, they can answer this as well. You know, I've been listening to these shows for the last couple of months. I'm even at times, a few times, that I have not called in, I've been listening to every single person's show. So I'm not sure if this was talked about in the past at all, and I really do not know the answer, but I would like to hear your opinion on this. One thing I want to bring up is what about nutritional deficiency? I did not know the answer, but I'm curious. Once prison food does not provide the nutrients to be able to adequately allow someone to have the correct amount of thinking power to fight for the innocent, food is powerful to bring and certain to
minutes. Let me jump in and tell you first of all,
my thoughts are, I see and I watch. I have a friend. She actually, I don't know if she was on the show here, but she just did the 60-day inside behind in Henry County. She actually served time down in Alabama, but she wanted to do a program because when she was there, she started the program where she started doing working with the inmates there. She learned how to speak Spanish. She learned how to do a lot of things, and she helped a lot of the women while she was down there behind bars. So when she got out, she went back, she did that program, and she touched on a lot of the things that are happening behind the walls. Some of these women don't even are able to even have sanitary napkins. They're not even able to have the necessary things that they need. You talk about taking a shower, where we can take a shower when we want to, when they go days without taking a shower. That mystery meat, we don't know what's in that mystery meat. You know, you look at some of the trays, you know, you can go on TikTok, you can go on these different places and see where they're posting these different things and how they're treating them. You know, if you're not able, if you don't have money and you're not able to get commissary, you're not able to buy extra stuff, then sometimes you go without if you don't want to eat what they're providing. These people know what they're doing, just like you say. It's to mentally mess with them. They know that they need nutrition. They need those vitamins. They need those things to function. And they want to keep you at a state where you got to depend on them, in a state where you don't know and you discombobulated. They don't want you to, they don't want you healthy. Look at these different cases where people went in prison healthy and strong, and they look like they malnourished now. And it's happened all over this place. And it's sad. And we on the outside, we got over 18 million people listening, but we can't be a voice. We can't speak up and say enough is enough. Chinchilla come on here every Sunday fighting for people that have wrongfully incarcerated and overly incarcerated, and talking about what's going on behind these prison walls. 18 million people are hearing this, but yet we still seeing the same things. When is enough gonna be enough?
Sometimes the change starts with that one person who just, you know, has that ambition and that power and, you know, gets the right people together, you know. And I definitely admire Tinsley for what she does, you know, because there's a lot of things when, you know, I listen, there's a lot of things, you know, my mother and my father were both correction officers.
This is Mr. Jerome calling back in.
Hello, this is a free call from an inmate at Connolly Unit. This call is being recorded and is subject to monitoring. To accept this free call, press.
You see what happened to him, Gianna, back in 2008. He was protecting his daughter.
Account 5. If you would like to permanently block your number, thank you.
I'm elated over here. Like, I love what I do. You know, the accolades don't matter, but I appreciate it because they paved the way. They paved the way so that we can do what we do. So I'm always grateful, and I thank you. I can't thank you enough for allowing us this opportunity, because you could have did, you could have said no, but I'm grateful that you said yes on that day. So thank you.
Congratulations. And also thank, yes, indeed. And listen, that day, we want to honor one of our great hosts because it wasn't for Matthias Queen. No, I'm not going to go into the story. People who know me know the story. I would not be here. And of course, you know, Angie, we already know. It wasn't for my twin. I would not be here. That's another story for another day. And now, we're going to celebrate this young lady because my soundtrack is all that. Mike to Mike to Mike. Yeah.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. You are tuned in to Walk in Purpose with Angela. We are live from Lagos, Nigeria. You can call in at 516-453-9133. Press 1 to join the conversation. We have caller number 4 in queue. Caller number 4, if you could tell me where you're calling from and state your name, please.
Hi, how are you, Angela?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Wonderful. You sound great. This is Antonia Betts, Angela, and I can tell you, you are definitely the right person for this show. I heard so much tonight that made me be so concerned about will there be another Angela ever to tell the truth. And bring on people to tell the truth as well. Well, we won't worry about it because I tell you, I think you pretty much had this one covered. You know, well, first, before I go on, if you don't mind, I wish to send my prayers out to Jerry, though, because to hear the state that she's in, I know she's going through some things when it comes to health. So I hope and pray for her to be able to recover. And just take it easy, because that's no joke. It sounded as if to say, the only thing she needed to do from here on is just rest. Now, Sister Betsy had really said some very wise things, just because she obviously saw potential in the subject matter you were covering. And the admiration for the resilience of your guests that you had on tonight. And I have to admit, you know, my heart goes out to him because he really is one of God's people, and I can hear it in his voice. And not only that, Angela, you know, I admire you're keeping him encouraged to let him understand you're still there. If he doesn't come back on tonight, I sure wouldn't mind you doing a part 2 to this if he's available or you're available to do it for him on your next show, because we really have to do something about this. When you two people are very good for being able to make sure people understand the unfairness of what all is going on out here against people who try to preserve humanity. And I really wish more than anything that you all keep up the good work and stay on that subject matter from time to time, because people don't realize the hatred some people have out here, which is insane. They're the very people on Sunday to give you the impression that they're out there not only to do their job, but pretend to be out there. And sometimes, whether lawmakers or not. And I really admire you two for just, you know, what I found out, inhumane people try to erase the humanity out of people like the guy who's trying to persevere under those conditions. I know we have bad people out here who are in jail, but we all have some of those who are really victims. And when he told us, when Ngozi told the story about his relative who had the little one in his possession when a guy was shooting at them, and he used self-defense to try to protect himself, it make you wonder whose side is the law really on. If you're supposed to have the right to protect yourself. And your child, too, I mean, whether the child was 2, 22, 42, 62, 82, the man he saw what he had done was not to harm nobody except for the person who tried to do him and his child in. So I hate to challenge the system because I believe in lawmaking and lawmakers, but not to the extent they try to destroy other human beings once in a while that we get to hear about and not tell the truth and be there as lawmakers for the right reasons. Hearing this, I hope that more people understand why voting is so important. You need to find out who those lawmakers are out there. And you need to follow them mentally. You need to follow them by just sharing information with people who you know that will take that matter seriously, or else it will get worse before it gets better. And that's how I used to hear it be said. You know, I was looking in Ecclesiastes, speaking of the Bible, and it had something to say at one point in one of the chapters about a wise man is on the right. I didn't like the way it was paraphrased about the second portion of it, but eventually I came across one version of a Bible. They said, but the foolish person serves on the left. In other words, they don't stop to think that serving on the right and the left and finding a happy balance in between is the reason why we have to stay adamant about letting the system understand that we are not pawns in their game. Maybe because some of you all don't pay attention to things you buy out there and invest money in it. And then the next thing you know, the people are taking you down are the people whose pockets you fill. You need to learn how to spend wisely if you can. And if you do every so often splurge, at least do it sensibly sometimes. Because this is the reason why you are where you are. You don't understand. People sometimes sit back and laugh at you because they feel as though they have nothing to lose. All I know, take my word. But I don't look forward to taking people down who work for law, because I came across those who have been really sincere about what they do. But it's because a lot of us don't speak up and tell the truth. I've seen some guys who are not as decent as they could be, who are on the side of being non-lawmakers. Well, how about the ones that have been subjected to things? Somebody ought to at least continue to do what you're doing and carry the torch. Hopefully, you will be able to continue to do so and be nominated for one of the awards, because, Angela, you really put your heart and soul into that. And as for your guests, I hope he obtains justice in the name of the God he served. Because when he even said that you have to eat breakfast at 3 o'clock in the morning, that don't even sound so good. That means, obviously, it's a disregard to him being able to follow the timeline and the time clock that every other person out there who's supposed to be of a proper nature in society, giving them the opportunity to live like human beings. So God bless you, Angela, and your guests, and anybody out there who just does not deserve it.
Thank you so very much for your kind words.
That was my guest.
You will be interested. My next show will be on November 28th. 2022, of course, at 9:30 p.m. on a Monday evening, and it's called Informational Guru. Take care, and God bless you again, Angela.
And I want to thank you for stopping by. That was the International Internet Radio Hall of Fame broadcasting nominee, Antonia Best. I tell you, it's always good to hear from her, the information guru. We have caller number 5 in queue. Caller number 5, would you state your name and where you're calling from?
Yo, this is Clever 1 1/2 of the Boons Brothers, representing from the Broad Street Bully side of Philadelphia. When you touch these, don't freeze your hands in front of City Hall. If you're trying to
trust them. What's going on, Claire One? How you doing tonight?
You're killing it as usual. You know, I just listen. It's always speechless on my end. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't see it no other way. You're holding it down because I know where you're from, girl. I know it. I know you know how to hold it down. But I just wanted to speak on a few things real quick. You know what I'm saying? You know, shout out to all my soldiers out there. Shout out to, you know what I mean, all the elders and all the unks that survived, you know, some of these cage affairs that they try to put us under. You know what I'm saying? And I'll say this, I'll bear witness to this, that, you know, some of the most righteous and noble of men I've met in prison. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, through my couple trips, you know, going on vacation. Sorry about that, folks. But, yeah, Clef One was on vacation a few times. But, like I said, any particular affairs, you know what I'm saying? I've met some good people, and they were strong, and they advised me well. And they are responsible for some of the things in which Clef One is upon as today as we speak, you know what I'm saying? I've met some real good-hearted soldiers. Unfortunately, we've done some irresponsible things to put ourselves in a inconvenient situation for ourselves. And sometimes we get pickled in by just having too much negative energy around us where we ain't doing anything. I'm just guilty by association. You know, and then the other thing I wanted to speak on real quick is, listen, my men out here, you have to, like, guard your... Man, you gotta advise your daughters, advise your girls, man, advise your nieces, advise your little sisters, whoever, man. You know what I'm saying? And furthermore, you know, I don't know if you women know, but according to the Sahuf, women are supposed to be chaperoned. You know what I'm saying? You know, especially when you're going from country to country and all these different kind of places amongst the, you know, you're walking around too loosely. That's the problem. You need chaperones. I'm Clef One, one half of the Booze Brothers, representing from the Broad Street Bullies out of Philadelphia, where we teach our daughters the kickbox transgressors in the balls. Check your satellite.
Clef One, when is your next show?
We're coming up on the 30th. You know what I mean? That's 30 shots. 30, 11 30 for the transgressors. Yes. So,
Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. I want to thank you for stopping by. We have final thoughts, and I want to bring Andre back up and allow him to share his final thoughts with us. I tell you, this has been an interesting night. This has been an interesting topic. I tell you, I thank you guys for stopping by and sharing, all of those that are tuned in on tonight. I tell you, I wouldn't have made this connection record if it was not for you guys. So, Andre, thank you for stopping by and sharing with me. What are your final thoughts? What would you like to leave with the audience on tonight?
You know what? I've learned a lot. I mean, considering, well, I'm just going to be honest with you, by me being from corporate America, I'm up there thinking, well, didn't they have a budget and all this and that? But I saw it from a different perspective. Then I started thinking, but then they have money on the books, you know, to get some of their needs that they, some to meet some of their needs. But then I realized, hey, this is something totally different, you know. Let me just sit back and observe and listen, because by me being from a, I kind of say corporate America, I just saw it differently. And then I realized, man, there's a lot of things that I didn't know. It's a lot of people hurting, especially behind them walls that people just tell you about. But other than that, it opened my eyes up. I don't take nothing for granted, especially being behind them walls. So I feel for most of the brothers and sisters out there. And I just want to share this, because I know I kind of cut you off earlier. I am an award-winning author. I can actually officially say that now. From a DAG Award, Distinguished Author Guild, of The Purpose of Being, won in the poetry category, The Naked Eye.
It was nominated for Motivation Inspiration. I heard the word truth three times tonight, and I'm going to share a poem regarding truth. Bear with me. The truth will set you free. Although it may tear the heart and even drive lovers or friends apart, it will, however, free your mind, heart, and soul. It may bring about respect and revitalize you as you seek answers that you already knew. Depending on emotions it may bring, whether up or down, don't stop living or breathing or even hide behind a frown. Today, truth can be a new beginning. We may think about yesterday, but it's important to pour into tomorrow's hope and ambitions. Hear and listen to the echoes of forgiveness as you yearn for the dreams of the future. Truth is like a piercing spear, seeking the blood of our inequity. However, with time, our wounds will heal, only leaving the scars of triumph and victory. And for those of you out there, you can purchase my book on Andre's Creation, UNDRASTREATION.com, andrecreation.com. You can follow me on YouTube as well as Facebook. Peace.
And Andre is one of the 122 authors from around the world that you guys will be hearing about. We are on the move. I am the visionary behind that movement. If you have not heard of us, you will hear of us. I am dedicated 2023. I will be pushing these 122. So be on the lookout for us. Jerome, are you still there? Quickly, your website so the individuals can shout, and then we're going straight in Gozy time.
So my website is justiceforjeronedevonnielsen.org. Devonnie is spelled DEVONNI. And you can purchase my book, Glass Wallpaper, there. You can purchase my book, Pink Poetry, there. And you can make donations to my legal defense fund to help me out of prison for being convicted after 20 years on a self-defense case. Just like the brother was speaking earlier, we didn't get to get into it on this show, but hopefully we will on another one. I was protecting myself, and I've been here for 20 years, and it's never came out. 20 years is never even entered the court. They've never even looked at the evidence. So I need all the help I can get, all the support I can get, and the Texas Liberation Collective needs all the help we can get with getting these laws reversed so that we can be paid for our labor in this enslavement that they want you to believe isn't still going on. Justice for Jerome, DevonnieWilson.org.
Well, thank you for...
Thank y'all for showing up. Angela, thank you for having me here. Congratulations on winning yet another award. I know you get nominated for awards like every time I go to sleep or I wake up, you got another nomination. And so that's cool. We don't keep on stacking up. And I appreciate the brother that came and reading his poetry. I actually need to get one of his books, and we'll have to put that together this time. So we've got to wrap it here. We don't do poetry, so we should probably do some building together.
Amen, amen. Well, thank you for stopping by. It is Ngozi time. Hold on tight and you will
I am going to bring on that, you know, that wonderful promotion before I go into Ngozi time. But tonight, move through because we have a problem. Your brothers are incarcerated.
Thank you for using Securus. Goodbye.
Absolutely nothing. We must be better. We must bridge the gulf between the have and the have-nots. The soundtrack is about empowerment. Someday, we'll all be free. Go back to our sponsors, and then I'll give you my go-to time.
Stop for the moment, oh, gotta get up, get going, going. You've been moving in slow motion, that headache got you prone.
Us on tonight. I tell you, sometimes we have to talk about those topics that other people don't want to talk about, that they're brushing under the rug, those things that are affecting us. So thank you guys for chiming in on tonight. Thank you for always supporting what we do over here on WBNN. Thank you, Brother O. I love you guys. Continue to follow the platform. Continue to support what I do. You can follow me on Linktree, Queen of Collaborations. I love you guys. See you guys back here same time in 4 weeks. Be blessed.